It just kind of happened. Situations like that, you just got to make a play. So I was just glad I was able to get the 1 yard for the first down.
We talked about your vision all year, but that play looked like it was flowing to the right. You stopped, go to the left. What did you see on that?
It's just heavy flow to the right. Obviously, it's supposed to go to the right, but it's just kind of, we have that discretion as running backs. If we see a hole, just take it. So,
how close did you come to staying on your feet and keeping that thing going?
I was pretty close, but like I said, getting the 1 yard was really all I cared about. It would have been nice to stay up, but maybe next time.
Is that big time when you see your coaching staff have confidence in the offense to pick up that 1 yard?
Yeah, that's something that Coach Dable has emphasized a lot this year. We get in those fourth and short situations. There's been a lot of times where Coach Dable was just like, go for it. So I think that shows, appreciate it. I think that shows he has a lot of confidence in us, and we haven't really let him down that much. So I think that speaks volumes about our offense.
How much did your offense, you guys change, or not change, but how much new things did you put into the game for that
climb? We just put together what we thought would be best for what they do on defense. Coach Dable did a great job of putting together the best game plan that would help us be successful as an offense. And then we had a lot of positive plays. We didn't have very many negative plays. We played well together. We played very efficiently, and we were able to have a lot of success.
Is this the type of week where you have to change your offensive signals because of the familiarity with our coaching staff being over here?
that's kind of a Coach Saban question. I don't know if they have that plan, but it kind of goes both ways. I'm sure we know a lot of stuff that they'll do and vice versa.
Obviously, the Clemson game, very emotional one. How do you guys sort of recharge emotionally with the quick turnaround?
I don't think it's that hard, just because of the fact of the way we felt all for the past year because we lost the national championship to Clemson, and that fueled us for an entire year. But we can't get caught up on that because if we're not focused on this game and we lose this game, then it's going to be the same thing all over again. So I think that if anything, we can kind of look at that and be like, okay, so we kind of got that game back that we wanted, but we want to keep that same feeling from happening again for the next year.
Damian, before the game, a lot of the talk was about the defensive line for Clemson, and Alabama's offensive line seemed to handle it pretty well from where we sat. What did you see up there?
Right. I mean, yeah, if he wants it. I don't really. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, what was your question? Talk about defensive line. I think our offensive line played very well, first of all. And I feel like those guys thought that they were challenged, being challenged as men. All they heard about all week and for however long is how good Clemson's defensive line was. So I think those guys took it personally, and they just came out and played with a purpose. You could tell that they felt like they had something to prove, and I think that they proved that they're one of the best offensive lines in the country, and they can play with anybody.
What about you? Is it weird to think 19 carries, that's your career high?
There was a lot of carries, yeah. It was fun, I guess. I would never complain about getting too many carries, but that was just kind of what the coaches asked me to do, so that was just what I did.
Derrick Henry, that's the first quarter.
Yeah, Derrick Henry was a different type of animal, but now we got a lot of guys that can go in and eliminate one guy from having to have all those carries, so I think that's been beneficial for us as well.
How'd you feel the next day?
Sore. Still sore, yeah.
And you, Rashawn, I was talking about the fact that you heard from some former players, some guys from last year's team during the week, including like Brian Anderson, I guess Ruben also. Hey, how much, if any, did you hear from guys? And if you did, just what kind of stuff did they say?
We know what guys like that expect from us. Guys that have been here, that have played here, and kind of laid the foundation for what we're doing right now, we know what they expect of us. And they don't necessarily have to reach out to us for us to even know. Even Coach Saban says stuff like that. He talks about how guys like Julio Jones, Mark Ingram, Marcel Darius, guys like that, they come to those games and they expect us to play to a certain standard. So that's something that we also keep in the back of our minds. And it's something, like I said, we don't really need them to tell us to play well. We know that when they show up to those games, that's what they expect.
How cool is that, though, that those guys keep coming around? They obviously care about this team, even though they're not on it.
I mean, I think it shows a lot about, you know, just the quality of this program. You know, you got a lot of older guys that are playing in the NFL, got playoffs to worry about and stuff like that, but they're coming to watch us play in these big-time games. So I think that's just kind of a testament to the way this program is ran.
What do you think of their linebacker, obviously Smith, the inside linebacker, number three? What do you think about him?
He's a great player. We're definitely going to have to get a hat on him. He makes a lot of plays in space. He fits the run really well. He drops in coverage. He's an all-around great player. I mean, obviously, he won the Butkus Award, but he's just a great player, and it's somebody that we definitely have to be focused on.
Do you guys as backs get any extra motivation knowing how much attention and how many yards Sony and Nick Chubb gotten?
No, not really.
A couple weeks ago, heard you talking in the hall, and somebody asked your opinion on something, and you said, well, if Minkus said this, that's what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
What does he mean to this team, and what's he been like in the playoffs?
I mean, he's our team MVP, so I think that kind of speaks for itself. Voted team MVP by his teammates, team captain, so I don't really think there's much I can say that isn't already known, but he's a great player, and you know, he's a signal caller for our defense and one of the overall leaders of our team, so I think it's pretty evident the impact that he has on this team.
Has he been any different, though, during the playoff?
No, same old Minka.
How much do you think the volume of the carries was as instrumental as just the production overall that you guys got as a running back group? I mean, just to have that and what it did and the effect of keeping you guys on schedule and also keeping the defense fresh during the game.
I think it helped us kind of control the tempo of the game. Anytime you can have success running the ball, you keep the clock moving, especially when you got a lead, you keep the clock moving, keep the defense off the field. That way, when they go back in there, you know, they can make plays on defense like they did. So I think it was good for our team. It was just what we were just taking what they gave us, and the run game was effective against this team, and that's kind of what we use against them. Every game plan is different. You know, whatever the opponent is, you just kind of have to match what they do and take what they give you.
Do